Hello dear students, welcome back to the NCERT science class of 6th standard. Dear students, in the previous class we have started the study of a new topic, that is the fun with a magnet, 13th topic. See dear students, we have studied about the magnet. Magnet is a substance. First time it was invented in the ancient time, when a shepherd with his sheep and goat, when he goes for the grazing, that time with his stick and whose metallic end is free, when he put on a stone and that stick was attracted and he needs more energy to pull out, then by this he come to know the something is present in the stone, and he gave the name as a magnet. By this name of the shepherd only, the magnet got its name. The next of this one, some books they have given about the magnet is obtained in a Magnesia, the name of a place where the magnet was first time obtained, that we have studied. And of this one, the applications of magnet, now we have studied. It is present in the doors of the refrigerators and windows and some windows, and next in the geometry boxes and all, in the pin box we are seeing the way we are using, and next in the speakers. In the speakers, what happens, the speakers, the magnets are using. Yes, and the different ways we are using the magnets. Later we study the applications of magnets. See, we are using the magnets for the separation of the metallic substance like iron from a huge heap, that we have studied the story in the previous class, that is how to separate the metallic substances from the other substances which are mixed in a heap, that is with the help of a crane whose one end or the movable end is having the one block of magnet. By rotating the magnet on the heap, see, it can be attracted, it can attract the materials, and that will be separated. Yes, the next of this one, how magnets were discovered. The first time magnets were discovered by the shepherd and all of the Magnesia. The next, the different shapes of magnets are present. The different magnets, there are two types of magnets are present. The natural magnet, which is obtained in the earth, in the soil, and the artificial magnet, which is prepared in the industry with the help of iron. And different forms of magnets are present. See, the first one is the bar shape, bar magnet, cylindrical magnet, horseshoe magnet, ball ended or the dumbbell shaped magnet, isn't it? These are the four shapes of artificial magnets, are they? Yes, that we have studied in the previous class. And next we have discussed the different activities to know the magnets and how the magnets attract the materials or the metallic substance like iron and gold. Yes, and also we have studied the magnetic substance and non-magnetic substance. Magnetic substance, and second one is non-magnetic substance, also we have studied in the previous classes. Magnetic substance means the materials which gets attracted towards the magnet. For example, iron gets attracted towards the magnet. The iron is called as the magnetic substance. Cobalt gets attracted towards the magnet. Cobalt is called as a magnetic substance. Plastic, it will not get attracted towards the magnet. The plastic is a non-magnetic substance. Yes, the material which gets attracted towards the magnet, such things are called as the magnetic things or the magnetic materials. The materials which will not get attracted towards the magnet, such materials are called as the non-magnetic substances. Plastic, wood, the other metals like copper, aluminium, zinc, lead, yes, sodium, calcium. You can take other metals that will not attracted towards the magnet. Such materials are called as the non-magnetic substance. The materials which gets attracted towards the magnet are called as the magnetic substance. Yes. Next, dear students, after this one, now we are going to study the magnet. We have to take one activity they have given. Take a magnet, take a bar magnet, bar magnet. It was textbook also has given in the page number 128. You can see the structure of bar magnet. Take a bar magnet. Next, we have to take the bar magnet. We have to be see rub the bar magnet in the different soils, different sands and all. See sands or the soils. Pull out the magnet, and are the some particles of the sands of the soils sticking to the magnet. Yeah. Now gently shake the magnets to remove the particles of the sands and soil. See what happens. Take the three bar magnets, and rub in the soil. What happens when you rub the bar magnet? What happens? The magnets attract the some sand particles. The sand particles, black color sand particles attaches on the surface of the bar magnet. You may play it in the childhood. See what happens. And try to remove the sand particles. Some sand particles, large sand particles you can remove, but fine particles that will be pasted or the attachment to the surface of the magnet, that is highly impossible to remove. Yes. See, the sand particles also contains the iron content, iron nature. That's why the soil is a red in nature. See what happens, dear students. You have to check by rubbing in different soil. See, first one mag, take three magnets, rub in one sand, one type of sand, and rub that another magnet in another soil. Take the third magnet and rub in different types of soil. See, you will get the different nature. Thus, up to the same time, you have to rub up to the same time. That is, for example, suppose for 5 minutes you are being in one soil, and that same time you have to repeat there also. Means five minutes you have to rub there in another soil. In next, in third soil also, the third magnet you have to rub in the different area, the different soils of different area, and you have to check the amount of soil attached to the magnet. You will see in all these three magnets the different amounts of soil is attached, because it is depends on the nature of iron content of that soil. In the soil, iron content is present. Because of the presence of iron content in the soil, we can find the amount of the soil or the sand on the bar magnet. Next, dear students, the poles of magnet. Poles of magnet. Poles of magnet. Pole means when you bring a stick. If you are having a stick, suppose I am having a duster. Duster is having the two ends, upper end and lower end. Two ends are there. These ends only called as the poles. The ends are called as the poles. The poles of the duster. Poles of the duster means upper pole and lower. In all the substance you will see, suppose for example in case of chalk piece, upper pole, lower. Yes. In case of magnet also, in case of bar magnet, In case of a bar magnet, the two poles are there. In case of bar magnet, two poles are there. See here, one and two pole, two ends are there in a bar magnet, in a cylindrical magnets. You will see the two ends, the ends of the magnet. In a bar magnet, two poles are there. The one is north pole, the second one is south pole. North pole and south pole. In a bar magnet, two poles are there. Poles means two ends are there. and the two ends are as a north and south pole. Shortly we are writing N for the north and S for the south. North and south poles are present in the bar map. Yes. See, next dear students, after this one, finding the direction with the help of magnet. Finding the direction. See, in your textbook he has given finding the direction. One term is there, finding the direction. Finding the directions. Finding the direction. See, in a bar magnet, here one activity is that we have to know. One story of the given. In an ancient China, one king, his name was that is Hongti, that is name, his name was Hongti, the king of China. On his car, that we can carry, that can carry, he used one statue. He fixed one statue with one stretched arm. In your textbook also has given that on the page number 129, the story, a king of China, his name is Hongti, and in his court he fixed one statue with a extended hand, a stretched hand, that and when he go while he is going in his court, that statue shows its direction, shows the direction on which the king has to go. See how he has fit the statue. A girl statue is there that he was fixed on his car. See, in that statue he fixed the magnet. He fixed the magnet. The magnet shows the direction. How the magnet is showing the direction? That we will study one activity here. See, take one bar magnet. Take a bar magnet and take one stand. Take one stand and hang the bar magnet with a thread. Hang the bar magnet with a thread. Take a bar magnet, take one stand, hang the bar magnet freely. Freely. Hang the bar magnet by tying with a thread, hang it freely. What happens? You will see that the bar magnet always stands towards the north and south. Always bar magnet stands towards the north and south. See, I try to rotate it. Try to rotate the bar magnet and leave it freely. Leave it freely, undisturbed. Slowly it will unwind and stands towards the north-south direction. North-south. This one is the north direction and here the south direction. It will stand in that way. Always it stands north-south direction. When we hang freely, it will not stand east and west. It will always, the bar magnet, naturally, the bar magnet stands north and south direction. By this, we can identify the direction of always in any corner of the earth, in any corner of the earth, when you hang freely the bar mandrel, it always stands north and south. Yes? Always it stands north and south. Next, because of this property, because of that property, the sailors in the boat who are going in the ship, going in the ship, the different countries, they are using the magnet. They use the magnet. The sailors of the boat, they use the bar magnet to know the direction. Yes? To know the direction, the sailors use the bar magnets. The next, dear students, is the Haunty's card also. The Haunty or the statues of the Haunty, the statues of the Haunty also contains the bar magnet. That's why the statue shows the direction to the King Haunty with the help of stretched arm. Yes? Next, dear students, and nowadays the advanced device, that is bar magnet only. Instead of bar magnets, needle magnet is using. Instead of bar magnet, nowadays a needle magnet is using. See, that is using in the compass. Compass has invented. Later, the compass has invented. In the compass, the needle magnet. A needle magnet is using. The needle magnet is also standing north south. This one is the north and here the south. Yes, needle magnet is using. The needle magnet is also to know the direction. To know the direction in the ship and in traveling. Vehicles and all, see the magnets, that is the compass is using. The compass is made up by a magnet, that is needle magnet, we can say a short needle magnet, that shows the deflection towards the north and south. Yes, north and south, that we can say the compass. Compass is a device which is used to know the direction. The compass is a device which is used to know the direction. Yes? The next, dear students, making of your own magnet. How to make the magnet? The magnet, that is, it is available naturally. Magnet is available naturally in the earth crust. Then it is also prepared in the factories, in the industry with the help of iron. Next, we are also preparing the magnets for few minutes. Means temporarily we can also prepare the magnets. How to prepare the magnets? In an iron substance, we are also preparing an iron thing. We can also prepare the magnet for short time. Temporarily we can also prepare. What we have to do? See, we have to take a bar magnet. Large size bar magnet we have to take. Bar magnet. Take an iron plate or the iron sheet. Or take an iron plate only. Here, but instead of taking bar magnet, take an iron plate, large size iron plate, strip of iron plate or the iron metal scale you are getting, iron metal scale you are taking. And next, take a bar magnet, always rub the bar magnet, one end of the bar magnet in one direction, in that direction only. Then next, in that, like that, the bar continuously in one direction, not in, a, in both the directions. In one direction, fastly. What happens when we rub the, when we rub an iron stick, when we rub an iron stick with a bar magnet continuously in one direction, what happens? The magnetism will produce. The magnetism will produce in the iron string. The magnetism will produce in the iron string. That is what as the magnet can be prepared temporarily. In the iron string, the magnet will prepare, means magnet will be, means the iron will show the magnetic property. Magnetic property, it means when I take this, take a iron string, thin iron string, and next rub with a bar magnet, and take the iron string and bring in contact with the any small strips of iron metals or the metal paper pins and all, that paper pins will get attracted. Bring the paper pin, see what happens. The paper pin shows the attraction. Attached to the paper pin shows the attaches. The iron that will not, naturally iron will not attract the iron. When we rub with the magnet, when we rub with the magnet, the iron strip shows a magnetic property and it attracts towards the, it attracts towards the material or the iron material. That's all about the today's class. The remaining we will study in the next class. Thank you.